where Kevin Green, Ric Flair, and the icon Rowdy Roddy Piper meet the Outsiders in six of the NWO. It'll be a night, gentlemen, where tradition will stand on its own two feet.
You know, tradition being guys like Piper, like Ric Flair, of course, you're the wild card in my mind, Kevin Green, but Roddy Piper, Ric Flair, masters of human chess, and they're not exactly getting in there with Deep Blue, Tony. They're getting in there with the Rat Pack.
All right, let's hear some comments from a man who used to be the world television champion, standing by in the locker room, Lord Steven Regal.
Dragon, you're holding something that means very much to me, the world's television title. Now, I may not do moonsaults and I may not do Hanukkah runners, but what I can do is out-wrestle anybody in the world. You can take your Ric Flairs, you can take your Hulk Hogan, you can take the likes of you, Sunshine, and I can out-wrestle you and I can out-beat you because I'm going away from the nobility for a while and I'm going back to my dirty, rotten scoundrel self that did his best at Blackpool Pleasure Beach at the age of 15, beating men twice his age. And that's what I do best. Watch yourself.
It'll be Regal's chance of getting that belt back coming up this coming Sunday, the World TV title against the Ultimate Dragon, a man he helped get the belt brain. I mean, he was a big part in the Ultimate Dragon winning that belt from Prince Iaukea.
Well, what I like is he says he's going back to his old roots. He's going to be mean and nasty like when he was as a kid beating up people twice his age. That's what I want to see Lord Steven Regal do.
Fans, if you just joined us later on in this telecast live here tonight, we understand Eric Bischoff contacted by Sting. Here's a cover by Humberto Guerrero, and Eric will conduct an exclusive interview with Sting live here tonight on Nitro from the jam-packed Baltimore Arena. And a great move that time, Larry, from Humberto.
Yeah, but why would Sting contact Bischoff? He can't be trusted. He doesn't have any authority anymore. He's been stripped. What's Sting got up his sleeve for tonight?
Well, you see him with the baseball bats all the time, but now he's going to talk to Bischoff one-on-one. Does that mean he wants to join the NWO, or he's going to admit he is a member? I have no idea what he's going to say.
Remember the last time we saw Eric Bischoff in the ring? It was last week with Hulk Hogan, where they made a challenge to Sting to come on in the ring and get a part of me, so to speak. Sting apparently going to give some type of answer to that. Here's been a great maneuver by the Dragon.
Boy, he dropped Humberto, got him right in the small of the back. Dragon, very aggressive guy. He's all over him, and we got a happy Sonny Ono walking around.
You know, if you think about it, Sting has something really that he wants to say one-on-one to Bishop. He'd do it to his face someplace else. This is something he wants the whole world to hear. It's going to be a very, very, very big announcement.
The Dragon, almost like a sleeper hold that time on Humberto Guerrero, the world television champion, top to bottom, spectacular event from the Independence Arena in Charlotte, North Carolina. And a jumping spin wheel kick that time caught the Dragon top of the head and got a two count to Randy Anderson, but only a two.
Not enough. Hard for Humberto to hold him down. Hoobie's giving up a lot of weight here, and the Dragon come around front. Oh, he got him anyway.
And a bread suplex. Almost got the three count. And what a major upset this would be. Only 6 days removed, Humberto Guerrero would go on to Slamboree as the TV champ. Up on top. Oh. Into a power bomb.
At that time, you can see the Dragon held his legs up so he fall right in the back of his head, and that's exactly where he got it.
You really can't waste any time, Brain, against Juventude, and that's what he's doing here. And Steve paid for it. No, he landed on his feet. Follow through with it. Almost got a sunset flip reversal into a three count that time.
If he'd have had his legs down over his shoulders, he'd have had him.
The Dragon to the attack again, hitting the near side rope. The moonsault. One, two, nope, did not get the three count that time.
Yeah, couldn't cradle him up.
Back to the attack once again. Big program, 1 hour here, live on Nitro. The exclusive interview, Eric Bischoff with the Sting. Coming up, here's a 1-2 later on tonight. 1-2 again. Something that, like you said, Brain, we've been waiting to hear from this man for more than 6 months now.
Oh, longer than that, almost a year. And he hasn't said a word to anybody. And now he wants to talk one-on-one with Bischoff.
Yeah, but why would he call Bischoff?
A lot of questions. Certainly, hopefully, will get answered a little bit later on here tonight, live. Call your friends, your family members. You'll want to be here later on in this telecast here tonight.
You know, I just thought of, I hope they're not setting Sting up for something.
Well, if Sting called them,
that's what we hear, though.
If Sting wanted to say something, he would just walk out and say it.
Look at this.
That's right, Larry. That's a great point. They are both up on top. Gigantic superplex. Released the man as he was hitting the mat.
Boy, see, anything off the top rope, you put yourself in jeopardy, and that's the result right there. Even Ono's getting upset.
There's Sonny Ono looking on.
What a great guy.
Yeah, you think
he is
so.
A great guy. Yeah, don't count the wooden yen.
Standing switch by Juventud, and a reversal of that by the Dragon. Both men go outside.
They're both getting up slow.
Dragon, first man to his feet, and now, after some spectacular moves from the inside, they're resorting to fisticuffs on the apron of the ring here.
But trying to get back in a position that Sonny Ono caught him from behind.
There's that great guy, Brain, caught him from behind, and Juventud grabbing Ono by the lapel.
Wait a minute. Blindsided him. What a great cheap shot that was.
If you think cheap shots are great, I guess you would be correct.
Well, if they're in your favor, it's great. Hard, Larry. Nice! Yeah! Oh, this man, Sonny Ono, is nobody to fool with. This man is a martial arts champion. What a guy.
Back to the attack again. The Ultimate Dragon. And there you can see, based on that kick he got in the head, and then the one from Sonny Ono,
that
he's dazed up. And there's his maneuver.
Yeah, Guerrero, he's already wobbly, and it just got taken advantage of by the Dragon. He's got him hooked right here, going back. That's pressure on the neck, brother, right there. He's tapping.
He's got him. He's got him.
The Dragon Sleeper is on, and it puts Juventud Guerrero out of the match. It is time for our Kestrel Torture Test of the Week, and it features a man who will go on to Slamboree this Sunday, still the World Television Champion, the Ultimate Dragon.
And look at this, off the middle rope, the Ultimate Dragon takes Juventud down. Beautiful blindside right here. Dropkick the man, jumped over the top rope, caught him. He never knew what happened at that point. Everything just happened, the lights went out. And watch Mr. Ono here. We get a shot of this. Obviously, Juventud said something to him seldom. You don't do that to Sonny Ono. Off the top rope. Takes his opponent, Juventud, to the middle of the ring. And I'll guarantee you, the man's going nowhere. Puts him to sleep. Good night.
Castrol GTX, motor oil that stands up to the most torturous conditions. Let's go now to Mean Gene Okerlund.
Just put him to